Welcome to the aviation world, guests. About the aviation. Aviation is the activity surrounding mechanical flight and the aircraft industry. Aircraft includes fixed wing and rotary wing types, morphable wings, winglets, lifting bodies, as well as lighter than aircraft such as hot air balloons and airships. Aviation began in the 18th century with the development of the hot air balloon, an apparatus capable of atmospheric displacements through buoyancy. Some of the most significant advancement in aviation technology came with the controlled gliding flying of Otto Lilienthal in 1896. Then a large step in significance came with the construction of the first power airplane by the Wright brothers in the early 1900s. Since that time, aviation has been technologically revolutionized by the introduction of the jet, which permitted a major form of transport throughout the world. Now, aviation technology. So, mobility and its pillar of transport are at very center of a social economic fabric. They underpin social connections and facilitate access to goods and services, including trade, jobs, healthcare, and education. Today's world, mobility by air, road, and water is all about efficiencies, speed, interconnectivity, and accessibility by all. However, this raises the issue about sustainability. The UN predicts that by 2050, two-thirds of the world population will live in cities one. How can we add depth and enhance today's already stressed mobility system for it to respond to our expectations and increased demands? In addition, innovation in technology and approaches are essential in redefining mobility. Cutting-edge technologies such as autonomous devices and ultra-light materials create opportunity to transform the mobility systems by enabling new business like the innovation in artificial intelligence, biometric, robotics, blockchain, alternative fuels, and electric aircraft. Aviation is therefore ideally positioned to support the innovation discourses and its potential impacts to new mobility. So, what is aviation technology? It is a broad field that covers various aspects of the equipment, hardware, and software used in flight operations, flight training, aircraft maintenance, aircraft security, and airports. Technology developed for the aviation industry is often more advanced as compared to other industries. Over the years, there has been a wide range of technological developments and innovations which have been integrated into the aviation industries. These advancements have been aimed at enhancing the functionality, ease of operation, and safety of the aviation industry. Regardless of the profound achievement recorded in the aviation industry, aviation experts and scientists continue to research tirelessly to seek new diverse ways in which they can continue to develop the technologies within the aviation industry by bringing innovative ideas and building on existing technologies and redesigning current aircraft structures. With the implementation of the new technologies, the aviation industry can be improved tremendously in the areas of flight services, efficiency of operation, development of the aircraft and airports, and most importantly, making air travel safer for everyone. So first, we'll talk about the automated flights. Automated flights, it is an aircraft autopilot system controls the aircraft without the pilot directly operating the controls. Said system is developed to reduce the workload of human pilots in order to lessen their fatigue and reduce operation errors during long flights. It handles most of the time intensive non-decision making tasks, helping the human pilots to focus on the overall status of the flight. Autopilot system uses computer to generate the control output. The control software reads the aircraft current speed, post height and location, and then issues control signal to a flight control system, which is lower level creator controller to adjust the control surfaces of the aircraft in order to maintain the aircraft altitude, height and speed while guaranteeing the lateral, vertical and longitudinal stability. It is anticipated that self-directed flights will become a normal occurrence within the few next decades. In aviation industry has witnessed a notable number of crashes which were mostly caused by human errors, and automated flights can greatly reduce those numbers. Regardless of the existence of crashes caused by autopilot system, it is projected that automated flights will be more safer and secure. Although automated flights will likely not completely replace human pilots in the cockpit, automated system can be configured to analyze various cockpit situations and use the information to add the correction necessary to avoid crashes. There is also a future for advanced automated systems in the air traffic control system to increasingly take on longer and more complex tasks and shift certain responsibilities away from human decision making in the control tower. Coming to 3D printing. 3D printing, also known as additive manufacturing, it is a method of creating a three-dimensional object layer by layer using a computer-created design. 3D printing is an additive process whereby layers of materials are built up to create a 3D part of block material. As a result, 3D printing creates less material wastage. 3D printing is also making headway in the aviation manufacturing process. Boeing prints a wing trim tool for the new 777 using 3D printing. In the past, manufacturing a tool like this with traditional methods would take several months. However, with the advancement in 3D printing, it is now possible in 30 hours. It is no doubt that as 3D printing technology develops further, it will make the manufacturing process for aviation products and aircraft parts much more efficient. Now, moving forward, let's talk about battery power flights. Technological advancement in electric power flight today will not only make the act of flying cheaper for you, crucially, they also promise to revolutionize how the aeronaut technology industry impact global environment. Airplanes release around 500 million tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere each year, representing a significant contribution to global warming. Electric flight replaces petrochemical consumption with cleaner battery-powered electricity. In the last 150 years, atmospheric carbon dioxide levels have risen an estimated 35%, and humans went from being earthbound, sending to 3 billion passengers into the air. The age of flight has an extraordinary carbon footprint. Consider that when a single person flies rounded from New York to London, the travel generates approximately the same greenhouse gas emission as heating a residential home for a year. Battery power engines or battery assisted flights are also slowly becoming more popular among certain aircraft. With improved battery technology and the use of deep cycle batteries, batteries can now sustain more power for a longer time, potentially making this type of power more viable for many smaller aircraft. This can be very practical for a large number of general aviation aircraft, flight school training aircraft, and commuter flight, because they are typically no longer than 2 hours and usually maintain a fairly close distance to a base airport for battery replacement or charging purposes. Now let's see what future holds for us in aviation. The aviation industry is not untouched from the effects of the digital wave, which has created a ripple effect across industries and organizations. However, it is not among the pioneers of the digital revolution. Instead, it is simply reacting to the new wave of technology and following the trends to stay at least with the demands and expectations of the modern passengers. In the past few years, low-cost carriers have become the preferred choice for passengers. The travelers now expect a completely personalized experience right from the booking stage till after they have completed their journey. The aviation industry can leverage sentiment analysis to determine their customers' need and then formulate their customer strategy accordingly. The International Air Transport Association has determined the technologies and factors that will define how aviation industry will shape in its recent report on future of the airline industry by 2025. The report identified cybersecurity, robotics and automation, 3D printing, new manufacturing techniques, virtual reality, augmented reality, IoT, big data, alternative fuels and energy sources, new aircraft designs, alternative modes of rapid transit, and geospatial technology to be prominent in the future of the aviation sector. The five major changing aviation industry: society, environment, politics, economy, and technology, which is also known as PEST model. While the societal, environmental, political, and economic factors are someone which is impossible to control. So, therefore, technology is becoming the prime concern for the aviation industry. With futuristic alternate travel modes such as Hyperloop, with the growing prominence of the highly sophisticated AR/VR technology, the aviation industry is in a rather dynamic state. Although air travel is still the preferred mode for long distance journeys, the tables might turn on the sector if it fails to adapt and align with the latest technologies. So this is the model of like how we can test an electrified airplane. So this is up to 24 megawatt high voltage airplane power grid. This is, and this is electric machine pairs to act as turbofans with an integrated electrical generators to produce thrust plus electrical power. So now you must be aware of what thrust is. Thrust is the force which help an airplane to move forward. And aviation industry, like in aeronautics, the friction, in layman language we call it friction, but in aviation technology we call it drag. So drag is the opposite force which is opposing the thrust. Electric machine pairs to act there. So this is the electrical machine pairs to act electric motor driving a boundary layer. Boundary layer is nothing but it is the thin layer which is joined to the, like when a aircraft travels, the air, the fluid, the gas forms a thin layer on the surface of the airplane. That is known as the boundary layer. This is a chamber, altitude chamber, to test at high voltage in a realistic flight environment. So, although currently in the very early stages of research and development, aerospace manufacturers are investigating the introduction of fully electric and hybrid electric aircraft. As battery technology develops, increased energy storage make electrically powered commercial flight a reality. Already, several and small-scale demonstrations are showing how it can be used for training flights and so-called air taxi operations, which are expected to start service in a small number of cities from around 2023 to 2025. This will provide 2 to 4% commuter flights to avoid ground traffic congestion. Longer term, several companies including Juno and Wright Electric are developing more familiar commercial aircraft concepts. This would be regional, jet size should haul craft, and could potentially be in service by around 2025. All the more research is needed. Thank you everyone. This was Sonal Sharma, the Assistant Business Development Manager at Air Cruise Aviation Private Limited, signing off. Thank you, guest, for being such wonderful audience. Thank you.